while we are non-dimensionalizing the equations, we see that there are dimensional variables initially that we have to handle. We have been using terminology as variables, parameters, quantities, etc., etc. Some of them have dimensions, and when we try to non-dimensionalize them, they change. There may be some example, they do not change. Then similarly, there are some examples that are known as dimensional constants and so on. And I try to give you a few examples just to mention so that you are familiar with these terms as well, because while we are working with equations of motion, we need to understand the terminology properly. So the dimensional variables or dimensional quantities in a given problem are of the example, for example, z, the dimension of a length, or it can be x also, and t, the dimension of time. So these are quantities that have dimensions, and they come under the category of variables. They are variables having dimensions. Then quantities that change or vary in the problem, but they have no dimensions. With time and length, I mentioned a little earlier that they have dimensions. Similarly, there may be quantities that they change or vary, but they have no dimensions. And their examples are angle of rotation when there is angular motion, for example, because theta is just a number. Or even if we are measuring the angular motion in terms of radians, even then they are dimensionless units. So if a motion in the rotationally direction clockwise or anti-clockwise taking place, and then there is a change, the angle may be changing, and the values may also be changing, corresponding values of the angle. But at the same time, the point here is that these things have no dimensions. And dimensional constant, another term that we come across is dimensional constant. So they have dimension, but they remain constant. A very simple and familiar example is that of gravity. Gravity is also known as acceleration due to gravity. So this will be having the same dimensions as that of acceleration. But remember, G always remain constant, and it has a constant value, constant dimension, and so on. So we gave you different examples, three different glaring examples and categories. One, variables that change and they have dimensions. Variables that change, they have no dimensions. And then there are terms that remain constants, although they have dimensions, such as gravity. Another important term that we use is parameters. Parameters refer to the combined set of dimensional variables and dimensional constants that occur in a given problem or in a given fluid flow situation. So, parameters are all those terms that play a role in a fluid flow situation, and if these numbers are changed, they can have an effect on the fluid flow. And they are combined, both they include both dimensionless as well as the dimensional variables. Pure constants are those things that do not fall into the above three categories that I mentioned. That is, they do not change. The earlier three things that we mentioned, they could change. They will change in a given fluid flow problem from beginning to end. But in this very case, there are also terms that do not change at all, and they are known as absolute constants, such as constant numbers that may be multiplying with a certain term in a fluid equation, or sometimes we have to multiply with it because of the fluid flow condition, such as we have half multiplying in the Bernoulli's equation, or there may be when we were writing the equation of motion, then we saw that t square is occurring there, that is the exponent 2 was appearing there. Similarly, the term, the numbers like pi, the exponentials like e, they may also be appearing in a certain equation of motion, but as you are all familiar, they are absolute constants and they do not change with the flow situation or even with the process of non-dimensionalization.